I can't believe it's been a really long time since the Peace of Augsburg.
It's been like 20 years since the Protestants and Catholics started fighting.
Yeah, I can't believe it all started when Luther and the Catholic Church separated. I have a Protestant here right with me to talk about the Edict of Nantes.
The Edict of Nantes allowed my people, the Huguenots, who were Protestants, to allow to be in the Catholic society in which everyone was equal and the Catholics would allow and give us more rights in their nation, which I'm very happy about.
Okay, what do you think about Calvinists still not having rights?
I think that's not very fair of the Catholic people because Calvinists are also Protestants, so allowing other Protestants like me have rights and not Calvinists is very wrong. Okay. Bad bye.
Do you think that there will be a war because of this conflict?
I think there will be.
I have a Protestant here to talk with me about the Holy Roman Empire. What do you think about the Holy Roman Empire?
I don't think the Holy Roman Empire should be in power since I'm a Protestant.
Yeah, so you think that they're the main power right now? Do you think that their decline is going to happen soon? Who do you think it might take over?
France.
Wow. There you have it, folks. Did you hear that the Letter of Majesty passed here in Bohemia?
Oh my god, no way, really? Does that mean we get rights as Protestants in this nation?
Yes. Yes, it does. But hopefully no one comes and takes it away. Whoa, Ferdinand too!
Taking away your Letter of Majesty and I'm ripping it up, you stupid peasants.
No, our rights.
This just in from Prague. I, the regent of King Ferdinand, am about to get thrown off a building into a moat filled with Oh no, here they come.
Hey, wait, he survived the defenestration of Prague.
Yeah, I'm back, baby.
Wait, we're on White Mountain. Wait, we're on White Mountain right now. This is about to be a battle.
And I'm gonna beat you up.
No, the Catholics are gonna beat us. No. Oh. No, stop.
No, stop.
I am the Lutheran King, Denmark King, helping the Protestants win the war.
I am Monson and Ferdinand Hart.
We,
the German princes,
are not happy with you.
Why? I established the Edict of Restitution, which took away Protestant rights.
Ferdinand II, you have Wallenstein under you, and he's a Protestant.
He's a dumb mercenary, and I'm going to assassinate him to satisfy the German princes. I, Ferdinand II, am going to assassinate Wallenstein. Boom.
Hi, my name is Gustav Adolphus. You can call me Gus. I'm the Lutheran King of Sweden and the father of modern artillery.
We're on Britain Field right now. We're the Catholics. We're going up against...
I am Gus, and I'm going to destroy you.
No, his cannon!
Long-range artillery is going to devastate us!
His long-range and mobile artillery is destroying us. This is a technological
movement! Cardinal Richelieu of France, I am a politique, and even though I'm Catholic, I'm here to help you.
Amazing! I would love the help.
Battle of Lutzen, King Ferdinand here, and I'm about to kill this. Gus.
Gus is dead! Gus is dead! We're funded by the Swedish. We are the French, and we are here to fight you guys, the Catholics.
No!
Alright guys, we are done of fighting. We need to sign this Treaty of Westphalia to end this 30 years war now. It's 1648, come on. I think we should make Switzerland, Dutch, and the Netherlands independent. We give Calvinism their rights, and we give people the freedom of private worship.
And we give France Alsace.
Okay, yeah, we'll give them Alsace, we'll give France Alsace, and then we will also result in Germany having inflation, bad economic problems.
I agree. That's a very good idea.
I want to give Germany.
like she's back in the atmosphere with drops of Jupiter in her head. She acts like summer and walks like rain, reminds me that there's